In this video, we'll cover class problem 21, where we use the timelines we created in problem 19, and we enter the cash flow amounts into the Excel wizard that will help us calculate NPV and IRR. We'll begin with IRR because it's a little bit easier. IRR and NPV are both functions that are built into Excel. We can find them by choosing the formulas ribbon, then click Insert Function, and then in the Search For box, we can type IRR. That's the function we're looking for. Any of the functions that uses IRR as part of its calculation will appear here in the Select a Function box. We want the one that's labeled simply IRR, Internal Rate of Return. Once we press OK, a wizard will pop up. The first field is asking for the values. Values are all the numeric amounts of the cash flows, whether in period 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, any number of periods. We're going to just automatically select these rather than choose them one by one. So we'll put our cell pointer, leave it in the value field, immediately pick it up and go over here and select all 5 cash flows, period 0 through period 4. The guess field is only there if you need to make a guess as to tell Excel where to start calculating. You can leave this blank because the amounts you'll be calculating will be very reasonable. Excel begins with 10% and then does some what-if analysis and goes up or down till it determines what the internal rate of return is. If the return was really huge or really small, then you would need to enter a starting point other than 10%. We can leave this field blank. We press OK. We see that the IRR, internal rate of return, is 6.23%. Since it exceeds the required rate of return, we can deem this investment to be acceptable. NPV is a little more complicated. We find the function for NPV in the Insert Function wizard. Up in the top function field, we search for NPV. All of the functions that have this as a component appear at the bottom. We want the one simply called NPV, so we say OK. There are 3 fields listed here. The first one is asking for the required rate of return. We can enter it in 2 different formats. We can enter it as a percentage, 5.42 with a percent sign, or we can enter it as 0.0542. We can convert it to a decimal. We cannot just enter it as 5.42 without a percentage because Excel will think that it's a really huge interest rate. Value 1 is our next field. It's asking us for the cash flow we anticipate at the end of year 1. Note that this wizard does not allow us to enter a cash flow for period 0. It only allows us to enter future cash flows. I could individually enter in value 1 the $3,050, in value 2 $1,910, value 3 and value 4. However, it's a little bit easier since they're all lined up together. If I select all of them and put them in value 1, I cannot select period 0. I can just select future periods, periods 1 through 4. So all of these go together in value 1, making the process a little quicker. Once I press OK, my answer gives me the present value of the future cash flows. The future cash flows are right here. What we want to calculate is the present value of all the cash flows. I double-click the function in cell C13, which contains the NPV of the future cash flows. I move the cell pointer to the end, and then I add external to the function The cash flow in period 0. Really, I'm subtracting, but since it's a negative number, if I subtracted a negative, it would turn it to positive. Once I do that, it gives me the present value of the future cash flows. Again, a positive amount tells us we will generate more than the required rate of return of 5.42%. Part B, we again look for the IRR function. So we select the wizard. IRR is already displayed down here because we recently used it. So this time, we don't have to search again. I select it and then press OK. To determine IRR, I select all of the cash flows, period 0 through period 5. Press OK, and the answer comes out in the wrong location because I forgot to put the cell pointer in the correct location. Moving it there and changing the format to percentage, this investment will generate about 2.5% more than the required rate of return. That means it's acceptable. NPV, we want to place it here. So I choose formulas, insert function. The NPV function is already displayed in the recently used function, so I choose NPV. Press OK. The rate this time is 5.2%. This time we will enter it as a percentage. Remember that simply entering 5.28 will not get you the correct answer. You have to tell it that it's a percentage. If you enter 5.28, it thinks it's 528%. Again, I'm going to enter all the future cash flows in the value 1 field. So I will select from cell D34 to H34. I then choose OK. And remembering that this is only the present value of the future cash flows, I double click it. And then on the outside of that function, I add the cash flow from period 0. Alternatively, I could have gone up here in the formula bar and did the addition of cell C34. So now I push enter. This investment exceeds 0, so that means that it will generate more than the company's minimum 5.28% return. Part C, we'll start with IRR. I want to select insert function, IRR, OK. I will then select all the values, the totals. I get an error message. So now we have to go back and see why did we get this error message. So I'm selecting D58 through J58, and that looks like what is here. Maybe one of these is not a numeric amount, so I'm going to check that. And it looks like all of these are numeric amounts. Maybe this one is not. Oh, that one looks like it's a numeric also. So let's just try this one again. We go to select the function, IRR. I will select all of these amounts. OK. I get a return equal to 6.41%. The investment will generate more than the company's minimum return required, and that means this is an acceptable investment. NPV, formulas, insert function. I choose NPV and select OK. My rate is 4.8%. I can even use the tool where I reference the number that I'm looking for. So I'm just going to leave the cell pointer in the rate field and select the 4.88%. My values for future cash flows are then selected in the value 1 field. I press OK. This is the future value, the present value of all the future cash flows. I can go up here in the formula bar and to this at the end of the function, add the initial cash outflow, and that gives me 19,333. This is not an indicator of profit or cash that my company will receive. The fact that it's positive, it tells me the investment will generate more than the 4.88% return. Part D, I select formulas, insert function. I want the, actually, let's go back and do this in the correct location. So this is where I want to put my IRR. So formulas, insert function, choose IRR, and OK. I will select all of my cash flows. My internal rate of return exceeds the required rate of return by almost 3%. That tells me it's an acceptable investment because it exceeds management's minimum required return. I want to put the NPV here. So formula, insert function. I want NPV. I select OK. My rate is 4.5%. The value field only values for future cash flows. So I select periods 1 through 6. I select OK. This is the present value of just the future cash flows. So I need to add the current period, time period 0, on the outside of the function, and I get 8274. Again, this exceeds the company's minimum required rate of return. How do I know that? It's positive. That means it's acceptable. This concludes problem 21.